In this video, we will talk about how to communicate Raspberry Pi with PLC Next. So we have a small project. So let me introduce you that I'm using a Raspberry Pi in my project, which has a sensor, and this sensor is giving the value of humidity and temperature of my room. Okay, this value is coming to the Raspberry Pi via this sensor. So the sensor is already connected. And now this Raspberry Pi is having a Node-RED inside, in which I'm getting this value, okay? Now I have a PLC Next. Now in this PLC Next, we know that there is an OPC UA server. Okay, OPC UA server. I want to push the values from the sensor, which is coming to the sensor or in the Node-RED, to this PLC via OPC UA, okay? So we will see how to do that. So there could be many different ways of communication. So the first one, which we will see, will be via OPC UA. Now in this case, we have a Node-RED in Raspberry Pi. We are not using Node-RED in the computer like in the last video. So Node-RED is running in the Raspberry Pi. I'm going to make some logic which will push the value from this Node-RED to the OPC UA server. That's the one way to do it. So it needs some OPC UA addressings, which we will see in this video. So in this case, we have a server, and the server we know is PLC Next because it has OPC UA inside, and the client, which in my case is, let me take another color, Raspberry Pi. So the client will push value in the server. So I'm getting two values in the Raspberry Pi already, which is humidity and temperature. I have to push these two values into the PLC Next. That's the task, humidity and temperature. So this way I can read the sensor, which are connected to a different controller. All right, so Raspberry is a different controller, PLC Next is a different controller. So I'm basically trying to build a communication between that. And how it is possible, if you're doing that as well, you have to make sure these two are in the same network. So at the moment, this is connected to a switch. These two devices are connected to a switch, PLC Next and Raspberry Pi. And my PC is also connected to the same switch. And they are in the same subnet. This is very important when you are building the communication. For example, my Raspberry Pi has an IP address of 192.168.0.88. And I think PLC Next is 192.168.0.210. So they are in the same subnet. So you have to make sure they are in the same subnet, or if you are using a subnet mask, it's exactly the same. So this you have to make sure. So once your Ethernet cable is connected to your switch for Node-RED, for Raspberry Pi and PLC Next and your PC as well, then you proceed with the programming. So I'm going to show you a small example here. That's my nodes in my Raspberry Pi, okay? So I will not go detailed into how the sensor is connected. That's not part of this lesson. The lesson is how they talk to each other. So humidity and temperature. So if I show you here, this is coming here. The humidity, 39.6%, and the temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. So this is my room temperature and room humidity, okay? These two values we want to push inside the PLC. And the PLC I can show you here. That's my PLC. And in the main logic, I have took two variables, which is humidity and temperature, two local variables. And these are type real. I took real because you see these are the real values. Temperature value could also be real, okay? So I took two real local variables, and I named it humidity, temperature, and I just ticked OPC, so I can rewrite the values of these in the OPC. So let's just verify these two tags in my OPC UA, in UA Expert. So this is my OPC server, and that's my value, humidity and temperature, and you see both are zero. There is no value, there's no connection, okay? Now what we do, we go back to our Node-RED. Now Node-RED, you have OPC UA client, okay? And this client is going to push value to the server. So I will go inside and I will define my server. So this is the IP address 192.168.0.210. That's the IP address of my PLC next. So you put it here, and this is the port address for OPC. And in this case, you can also read or write. So I will do write, okay? And I click done. So what I'm going to write now, I want to write the value of humidity, okay? So this humidity is coming here. So I just took this is a link. So I can take this link from here. So this is just the parallel way to get the value. So instead of taking the node like this, I prefer to make it a clean way of programming. So I use a link, and I use this link here, and I check it as humidity, okay? So before I connect this to OPC UA, I just want to show you how this link is working. So I just take a debug node, and I deploy. So this is coming from here now. So this node is this node. So this link is working, perfect. So I will just delete it for a moment. Now to write to the OPC value, what do you need? You need a payload and you need a topic. The topic is the address of the tag, and payload is this humidity. So I have this payload, but I need a topic. So where should this value go? That's the topic. So I have to take a function here where I define the topic. So I connect this link here, and inside the function, I will write message dot topic is equivalent to two commas, and inside this, I will put the address, which will come from here. So this is humidity, copy value, put it here, paste, and a semicolon. That's it. So you don't have to write a payload again. Payload will automatically be moved. You just have to define the topic. Click done. And now I show you this again. So deploy. And now you will notice you have the payload, but this is the topic. This whole thing is the topic. This is what we need. Now what I'm going to do, just push it here. I don't need to show that. And deploy. And now this has started moving the value. Okay, wait, what is the value? Cannot read property match. Okay, one more thing. When you define the topic, you have to define the data type. So I will put, I forgot to mention, data type is float. Done. And deploy. This time it should work. So now this is moving the value. It says active writing. And now let's go inside. Check UA Expert, and we see the values coming, 39.6. You can also see that in PLC Next. So humidity is coming now in the PLC. So this is just an example that if you have a different controllers having different sensor values and you don't want to take the wire from the sensor to your PLC and measure it again, no. Just talk to the controller by OPC UA. So I'm just getting the value of the sensor which was connected to Raspberry Pi. Now the value is coming to PLC in a data block. So the sensor value is traveling via OPC UA to your PLC. This is one way. In a similar way, we will also get the temperature. So what you can do is go back to the Node-RED, and now I want to write temperature. So I will take another link. I will do this copy paste, and I will check temperature. And this one I also want to write. So I will copy this node. And now I will copy the temperature, copy value, I will open this one, and here I will change this to temperature. The rest is fine. This is also going to write to your OPC UA. So just deploy. So now both the tags are being updated. So if I open UA Expert, you can see the temperature value is 25. Also in PLC Next, temperature value is coming. All right, so I hope this makes sense. And via OPC UA, which is the OPC UA server, which is inside the PLC Next, you can use it for read and write operation using different clients. In this case, the client was Node-RED. So this was one way of communication between Raspberry Pi and PLC next. Okay, this was the first one which we just saw. So you can similarly do OPC way with different clients. So you can have different Raspberry Pis or different PLCs, and you can use a client to read write the values. In the next video, I will show you another way which is much more easy in our situation. So I'll see you in the next video for the next case. Thank you.